Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize the editing dialog in the Blazor Kanban component using templates. I will also show you how to add a new card or modify the existing card details with the editing dialog. Let's start with the coding part. I'll open my existing example where the Kanban component is configured to show software development work in progress. If you want to learn how to create a basic Blazor WebAssembly app and add a Syncfusion component, please refer to the video linked in the card above or in the description below. Let me run this application now. Look at the output. The Kanban component is rendered with work in progress data. Here, by default, I can edit the card details in a dialog by double-clicking on a card. Notice that the dialog opens with the fields ID, status, and summary. By default, the ID field is displayed with an input editor, the status field with a drop-down editor, and the summary field with a text area. Also, you can see the dialog footer is displayed with three buttons: delete, save, and cancel. Here, you can use the save button to save the modified details of the card, or use the delete button to delete the card. Now I'm going to show you how to customize the dialog fields. To customize the Kanban edit dialog, I need to use the template property. So, first, I will add the Kanban dialog settings tag and include the template property. Then I'll create an implicit context parameter to access Kanban data model and store it in a variable named task details. Next, I'm going to define the fields. For that, I will add a table tag to show the data in tabular form and add the other relevant tags. I include table data element and the built-in class e-label to display and align the label. I include another element for editor control. I'm going to show five fields, so include table rows and data accordingly. Here, I have planned to show a text box for the ID field. To use the text box, I will import the namespace syncfusion.blazor.inputs. Then, I will add the label as ID. Next, I need to add the SF text box tag with the built-in class eField to align the text box. Then I add the value property and bind the data from task details. Since this field is unique, I add the enabled property to prevent editing in this field and set its value to false. Next, I'm going to show a drop-down list for fields like status, assignee, and priority. To use the drop-down list, I need to include the namespace syncfusion.blazor.dropdowns. Here, set the label as status. Then, I'll define the SF drop-down list tag with the built-in class eField to align it. Now, I need to specify the data source type in tItem property as Kanban data model, and value field type in tValue property as string. Next, I'm going to bind a data source to this drop-down list. Here, you can see that I have already defined the priority, status, and assignee data in single list inside the Kanban data model class. Now, I will assign this data to the template fields. So, inside the @code directive, I will get these data using the getTaskProgress method and store them inside the list variable progress details. For this drop-down list, I'll define a data source property and assign the variable progress details. Then, I include the @bindValue property to perform two-way binding between the drop-down list and the Kanban. Then I need to map fields using drop-down list field settings tag and bind the text and value properties to the field status. In the same way, I will add a drop-down list component for the assignee and priority fields. Finally, I will show a text area for the summary field. So, I will include the SF text box tag and enable the multiline property to display it as a text area. Then, I include the built-in class eField to align the text area and set the @bindValue property to perform two-way binding between the text area and the Kanban. That's it. I have designed the dialog fields. I will run this example and show you the output. Here you can see, the edit dialog will be opened when I double-click the cards. I'll change the status of this card and save it. Note the card, its status is updated. I'll also delete the card using the delete button in the dialog. At last, I will show you how to add new card data to the Kanban control using an external button. First, I add the button with the built-in class e-button to align it. Then I label it as add new card. Then I add an onClick event and assign the callback method showAddCardDialog. To call the Kanban built-in method, I add a ref property and initialize the Kanban instance. Inside this callback method, I will auto-generate the ID based on the task count and pass the data to open the Kanban dialog using the OpenDialog method. See the output, the dialog will open when I click the Add New Card button. I will enter or choose the details and save it. The entered card details are displayed on the Kanban board now. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen. I have shown you how to customize the dialog editing in the Kanban control using templates. Also, I showed you how to add or modify the card details in dialog editing. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also grab a free license key to use our Blazor products if you're eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel.